Hello everyone. It's me the Varex again with a new tutorial. Today I will be showing how to change the color of a product. Changing color of a product isn't that hard when you know how it's done. First of all, you have to be a creator on Imvu. In order to access to the creator program, click here to know how to become a creator. In this lesson I will teach you how to open the file on creator mode, and how to change color using Photoshop. Now let's derive the product which we are going to change the color. If you don't know how to derive a product, then check out this video. Here is the product which we are going to use on this lesson. Go all the way down until you see this hyperlink. Click the link, and wait till it open on Imvu creator mode. I prefer working on a darker room. In lighter rooms it's hard for me to focus on small details, because of the bright background. But these are my preferences. You can set these things as the way you wish. Okay, now it's open for editing. Let me change the default look of this avatar and change the room to a darker one. Let's get back to where we were. So be sure you are on the Mesh tab. And under Materials, click the second icon. Here under Texture Assets, you will see two more icons. The left slot is for the texture, and the other slot is for the opacity. We use opacity to cut out or use transparency on a mesh. For example, if you want to make a lace top, a sheer top, or just cut out a portion of the product, then opacity comes in handy. But let's not talk about the opacity for today. So it's the texture slot we use for changing the color. Now go back to the product and search for the texture file. Some meshers have provide the bump maps on their product page. Meshers are the ones who craft these shapes and other products on Imvu, like furnitures, accessories, clothes, etc. However, these bump maps comes with bumps and wrinkles on the surface. I wish that all meshers provide these files, so that we don't have to create those bumps and wrinkles. Now save the texture file on your computer. Open Photoshop, go to the file option on the menu bar, and then click open, or click Ctrl plus O, and search for the file, and double click to open. Before starting to change color, I want to highlight one more thing. Go to the product page, and open the UV map. As you can see, the mesher has set one material for the front view, and for the back view as well. So that means we have to change only one file. But if the mesher has set them into two materials, then we have to work on more than one file. I will show an example of these kind. Here is a product I found which has more than one material for a single file. Let's open it. So here we have three materials, which means if we want to change the color, then we have to change these three files. The reason why meshers use more material is to give more details. Okay. Let's get back to Photoshop. In Photoshop we have few ways to change the color. I will explain the most frequent two ways I use. First way, create a copy of the layer by dragging the layer into the Create New Layer icon, or use the shortcut, Ctrl plus J. Go to the image from menu bar, then adjustments, and hue saturation, or use the shortcut Ctrl plus U to call up the hue saturation window. To make the color you want, play with these settings. The more you practice, the more you will get used with these adjustments. I will make blue for this, and when you get the color you want, hit OK. Once again, create a new layer of the background. Drag the layer all the way to the top, and call the hue saturation window to desaturate the layer. Drag the saturation arrow all the way to the left, to remove the color from the layer, and hit OK. Go to the layer mode, then select soft light from the drop-down menu. This step is very important, or else we will lose the lightness and the darkness from the texture. Second way, delete the middle layers, by dragging them into the delete layers, or simply hit the delete button. Create a new layer in between of the two layers. Select the background, and click create new layer icon, or use the shortcut Ctrl Shift plus N, and press enter. Click foreground, and choose a color from the color picker window, and hit OK. And click Alt plus backspace to fill the color. Now go to the desaturated layer, and make two more copies. So that's the most frequent two ways I use. You might find other methods easy for you. Go to File option from the menu bar, and then Save As, or click Ctrl Alt plus S. Save the file into JPEG format, or PNG format. I recommend PNG format. However, I use both formats cause I'm just too lazy sometimes. Go to Imvu, and click Edit button. Choose the file we saved, and then click Apply Changes. That's how to change color. Now click Save button and then click Upload. A new window will pop up for product submission. Check the submission help from the right side of the window, and fill the form. After complete everything, click Submit to Shop. That's all for today's tutorial. If you have multiple materials, then you have to repeat these steps for all the files, which is a bit difficult, so for these kind of situations, I take the advantage of the Actions panel. Check out this video to learn about using Action panel to change color. Thank you for watching. Hope this was useful.